There's something beautiful about a pair of dark wash denim in pristine condition. But sometimes, you just gotta let out your inner bad boy. The right pair of distressed jeans can look amazing. The problem with store-bought distressed denim is it doesn't always look very realistic. But what if I told you, it's easy to take a pair of jeans and distress them yourself? Thomas with Real Men Real Style here. And in today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make an awesome pair of distressed jeans. Here are the tools you're gonna need to get started. First up, a fabric pencil, low grit sandpaper, a lint roller, a razor, tweezers or a seam ripper, a piece of cardboard, a pair of scissors, a knife, or another sharp cutting tool. Step number one, mark your cuts. Plan out where you'll be cutting the jeans before you start. Just going crazy on them is unlikely to yield the result you want. The key to great distressing is to make it look realistic. Stick to weathering the parts of the jeans that will naturally get the most wear and tear. The main area you want to weather is the knees, but don't forget under the front pockets, where keys and other items can wear down the fabric over time. Take the fabric pencil and mark where you want to create your holes. Draw a few horizontal lines. Try to avoid making them the same length though, as that starts to look too symmetrical and artificial. Remember, gents, less is more. Going overboard on the distressing is not a great look. Step number two, start cutting. There are a variety of items you can use to cut your jeans open. Whatever you use, be careful to only cut the top side of the fabric. If using a knife, I advise putting cardboard between the two layers of fabric to protect the back side of the jeans. Cut through the lines you drew with your fabric pencil. Go ahead and flip your jeans inside out. It's time to start pulling some threads. The black or blue threads of the jeans run vertically. The white threads run horizontally. Now take your tweezers or your seam ripper and start to pull up the white threads one by one. As you continue to pull up the white threads, the vertical threads are going to start to create excess fuzz. Go and take your scissors and trim those as they start to build up. I do recommend leaving a little fuzz at the edges, as to my eye, it looks more realistic than a super clean edge. Keep repeating until the hole is as large as you like. You can pull just a few threads if you like the holes to remain tidy. But if you like the aesthetic of a lot of threads, then keep pulling until you've fully connected two of the cuts. You may end up with a few white threads that aren't connected on both ends. Just use your scissors to trim those off. The next step to weather your jeans is to use some good old-fashioned sandpaper. I recommend using something rough like a 60 or 80 grit. Sand over the holes you created in the previous step. This roughens up the edges, making them appear more natural. Roughen up any raised areas that would also receive wear and tear, like the top edge of the pockets or the belt loops. Finally, with enough scraping, you can create unique holes in the fabric different than the holes you made with your scissor or knife. Keep sanding until you are satisfied with the level of wear. The sandpaper will lift up quite a bit of fuzz. Simply use a lint roller to remove it. Another way you can tear up the jeans is by simply grabbing your razor blade. This is a great tool to cut up the fabric edges without creating extra fuzz like the sandpaper. Simply lift up the edge you want to cut and run the razor back and forth. Just be very careful not to cut yourself. So guys, when it comes to distressed denim, are you team black jeans or team blue jeans? Let me know in the comments below. Step number five, wash. Finish off by sending the jeans through the washing machine to clear away any loose threads or fuzz. There you have it, gents. Now you have the perfect pair of distressed jeans. But what do you do if you have a dirty piece of clothing that you want to bring back to life? Check out this video right here, gents, where I'm going to show you how to make your white sneakers look new again.